So Blue's working title was Red, oddly enough. The story with this song getting started was after the Meredith and Holmes tour. I took a little bit of time off, like 2 or 3 weeks, a month off, and was going to come back and build a studio at my house, build a new studio, and I was going to take about 2-3 months to do it, and it wound up taking about 9 months. So it was pretty chaotic, and I was working in the meantime, but nothing, you know, nothing really getting done that as much work as I wanted to get done. And so when the wiring finally got, the initial wiring got set up in the studio, hooked up a bass, put up a sound, put up a drum beat, and Blue came out fairly quick. It's kind of strange with a bunch of construction workers around you. You're playing guitar or bass or something. And but I just wound up keeping that first take run through of that. It's the one that made the record, and the guitar was added later, but the guitar is obviously pretty haphazard, messy first take, happy accident thing that I thought was pretty fitting. I don't know. It just seemed to work out. The bass is so surgical and precise, delay, keeping it in time and everything, needed some kind of offset. And Josh's drums on this were really cool. I think he nailed this one second take or something. It was really fast. And the I love the little ghost snare in there, the background snare sound. I think it was really cool. And as far as the video goes, I think the contest winner, Joseph Perez, did a really good job on this. And we looked through a lot of videos. There was a lot of entries from the contest that we ran online, and this one was the clear winner to me. It conveyed a lot of emotion. I think it was pretty upsetting to see. You know, I think the message is pretty disturbing, but pretty accurate, the feeling you have for losing a loved one. Anyone who's lost someone can probably relate. And I think you did a really good job.